What do you get when you combine a 57 Chevy with the ultimate barbecue? Today, my fellow USC alumni, Al Bautista, is going to show us how he took his 210 wagon and turned it into a masterpiece. Everyone, I'm Christine Danchuk, and I'm here today with Al Bautista. Thank you for joining me. So tell us a little bit about this 57 that you turned into this amazing grill on wheels.
I picked up the car from a property I sold. The car was sitting in the lot. The owner, once I told him to get it off the property, told me to take it, so I did. First, it sat there for a few years, and then I decided to work on it. This is what came out. Yeah.
So how much time, dedication, and hours did it take to put into this car?
About 4 months of every day. So it wasn't a lot of time as far as cars go, but it was 4 months of daily beating, cutting, welding, prepping, till it was done.
Till your masterpiece was done. Is it now complete?
Very close, very few things needed. Mm-hmm. At first we didn't intend it to drive as much as we have been driving it, so I'm gonna change out the power steering. Well, put one in because it doesn't have one.
Oh, okay.
And chrome up the brake booster, but other than that, I think I'm done.
Tell us a little bit about what you did, how you installed everything to make this an amazing mobile kitchen.
Well, the original idea was to have a car that cooked. Uh-huh. And we started thinking, what do we need to have in there to have fun? It's got a flat griddle, it's got a charbroiler, it's got an electric steamer, it's got a deep fryer, a hot dog steamer, a couple of crock pots, and a kitchen sink.
Well, I think you're not missing anything. I think you got everything going on there.
Everything, including the kitchen sink.
Wow. I think the best part of this is that you can make it a family event, because during these tailgate parties, you get to hang out with your friends, your family. What special memories do you have with your family?
I built it 10 years ago, and my oldest son is 11 now. Mm-hmm. So all of my kids have been coming to the tailgates. They love it. They're mad when they're not here with me.
So when you were working on your car, putting it together, how was Nanchuk's customer service? Were we able to help you with everything that you needed to put your car together?
Actually, I think every guy that works there was very knowledgeable,
because that's good to hear.
This is the first car I built, so I didn't know everything about it. I learned as I went. That cutaway on the showroom floor was a real good tool for me, because I'd go in there and see what I was missing and how it went to put it back together. And sometimes I had to explain what I needed, and they would find it in the book. I mean, they knew what page, they knew the part numbers, and I was like, cool.
How did you hear about Danchuk?
There was actually a piece of floor inside the car when I bought it, and it had a Danchuk sticker. They hadn't placed it into the car. So when I started looking for parts, I just looked up Danchuk. They had everything I needed. So after a lot of trips to the store and a big shopping list, and I have several of those catalogs to find all my missing parts, and now it's done.
I'm so glad we were able to help you.
Oh, definitely. There's no way I would have done it by myself. I mean, it would have taken me years at a swap meet to put this car together. I'm glad I found that sticker.
Well, thank you, Al, for letting us join you for this amazing tailgate party. It was so awesome.
Thank you for coming down.
Thanks, everybody, for watching. Go Trojans! Yeah.